Don't waste your time trying to prove things where someone is quite closed off. Hello Libra, welcome new viewers, cross watchers and my lovely, lovely moonians. This is a monthly reading for Feb 2020. We will be looking into love and what the spirits have for you. Alright, the cards are quite ready, so let's see what's coming in. The first card coming through is flirt, extend your light-hearted energy to others. So what I see over here is that in an exchange of all the heaviness that has been going on, when you are interacting with other people, let the energies be a little lighter is also what is coming in. Let's open our life to have some more fun kind of energies coming through. Flirt is coming in, which is talking about lightening up your load a little. Too much stress that has been going on, and now some fun adventure will be very nice, but make sure that you're not overly doing it or trying to portray something which you're not, because it may become very much impressionable. That energy is coming through because we have the Mercury retrograde starting 16th or 17th of Feb and going into March 10th or 9th, depending on where you are. So communication will be a little bit of blur. And also there's a need to become aware of what are your thoughts and how are you feeling about it. And in general, are your thoughts and your feelings coinciding? That is also what is coming through. Alright, I'll just go ahead and then we'll talk about it. We have let go of control issues. Allow this situation to unfold naturally. This card comes up quite a bit whenever I use this deck. It comes in for you guys. What I see is that, like, you know, trying to stage a certain kind of a way or someone understanding you, that kind of a energy or mirage kind of a thing is coming in. Be your authentic self is coming through. Although it never really happens. I don't find Librans having a difficulty in doing so. But maybe in the way that, like, you know, you may be trying to impress someone wherein you have a more quieter or a more wiser approach to life, that kind of a energy is coming in. Maybe that's why when you come out to become a little authoritative or try to impose a certain kind of, not impose, but try to direct someone's thoughts onto a particular situation, they find it quite difficult to understand because they were used to seeing you in a particular light and then there's this person coming in. I'm not saying, like, you know, you have to change yourself because of someone else, but it's just that, like, you know, just showcase who you really are. That kind of a thing is coming through. And don't get too fixated on the future results right now. We are being asked to focus on the now and have a little bit of fun. That energy is coming through. Let's not weigh things down at the moment. Not really the time to start something new, but yes, completions are something which you can think about right now and reflect on things is the energy which is coming through. Getting a little tired, that is the energy which is coming in. Anyways, let's see. We have codependency coming in. Addictions are affecting your romantic life. If there's any kind of closure that you want, now will be a nice time to do so, whether it is personally or with another person. And yeah, I do see a little bit of karmic energy which is coming in. Maybe that's why what I spoke initially could be for the other person as well, that they may be a little bit of a flirt and you may be trying to make them understand that we need to channel things out and, like, you know, let's just get something constructive and let's get things clear kind of a thing. And in that shifting or sieving things, there's this energy of codependency which comes through. Codependency doesn't really last. It becomes an addiction. Like, even in being together, even if it's an unhealthy relationship or a toxic one, but we become habitual to having that person. Even if it is, like, you know, we are fighting again and again, but we're too in sync or too codependent or used to that person that we're not being able to break from that. There's certain kind of cycle change which is coming through, which is very important. Codependencies tend to become, like, you know, I don't want to use harsh words because all throughout the harsh words were coming in and I'm just trying to tone it as much as I can. So if this has been a little annoying for you up till now, trust me, this is my best way of saying it because I have a few more harsher ways of explaining what is coming through over here. But nonetheless, let's understand what is becoming obsolete in our life or taking up too much time of our life, that is also what is coming in. Healthy environment, healthy mindset is required for you to grow. We have separation coming in. Time apart from your partner is on the horizon. Maybe we just require some time, and maybe there are certain kind of frustrations which are coming through right now, and you both are too sensitive and vulnerable, and the volatile side is coming out where both are becoming defensive and a bit too much of argument is going on. The universe is saying, like, you know, even if you want to keep going with this person, and that's perfectly fine because they may be your soulmate, it's just that, like, you know, you both may be going through some tough transformations, and doing it together may not be really helping because there's a need for self-discovery also which is required. So time apart, emotionally being in your own sphere for some time, or the fact, like, when this is coming in, let go of control issue. Don't have to always pin down to make sure that you are proven right. It's not going to help right now is what is coming in. Someone may be close-minded at the moment. So save your energy is what is coming through. I do see a bit of karmic relationship that is going to come to an end. If you are in a toxic relationship, that needs to come to an end is also what's coming in. Free yourself from such a situation. That is what is coming through. Understand what you truly deserve. And when you get the clarity of that, you'll immediately get the strength to move away from this. Maybe the separation in energy, maybe physically going into different states due to work and stuff like that will just give you a head start and the space to breathe. That is what is coming in. The space to breathe. Because when I saw the flirt card, it wasn't really... I'm having a hard time trying to explain things because I don't want to be too harsh right now. But yeah, the karmic stuff and all this toxic thing, it just needs to go. I don't want to spend too much time in it because it's really pulling me down. So me tapping into the energy is quite enough. Don't suffocate yourself like that. And new moon in Pisces will be a nice time to just release certain things. And Leo full moon also will be a very passionate time, but take time to really see what are you paying attention in your life. Where are you extending your energies? That is also coming in. It may be like, you know, you're in a very healthy situation and this may not resonate with you, but there is a strong energy which is coming in and letting you know you have the chance to reflect on the reality of things and make the changes if you want things to change for the better. That is what is coming through right now. It could also be that, like, you know, since you are already here, this may be happening in someone else's life and you may be getting the intervention for them. Perhaps it's that. We have nine of this coming through, which is talking about people hearing you. Professionally, things are looking good. You have a captivated audience. It could also be that you have just recently separated from something or taken a new path in life. And with that, this is just encouraging you to go forward. When you step out of the house, imagine like 1,000 men if you're a female. I always like to think about that if I've had anything like an emotional roller coaster. When you step out of the house, imagine like 1,000 men just waiting to see you, that kind of a thing. How will you react kind of energy is coming in. We have the queen of this also coming through over here. Financially, things are looking good. Believe in yourself. This is a very loyal queen who is very sure, who is very grounded. And irrespective of her height, she has a tall personality. That is coming in. Being in control. Letting go of the hypocrisies. I don't know why is that coming through, but seeing things black and white and choosing what she wants and really cutting cords with all those things that is no longer respecting her. That energy is coming through. We have the sun card, a little bit of cloudiness that may be there, which may be causing a little bit of delay or uninspired time. So what is required is for you to believe in yourself and stop resisting what is due. An ending, an inevitable ending which is coming in. That is what is coming through. Or if you are already in the path of healing and moving away, recently broke up from a toxic karmic relationship, the universe is supporting you on this process. We have the King of Arrows coming through. So yes, I do see, unless and until this person becomes more independent as an individual, thinks more clearly, more rationally about things, and really owning up to what they have done, because that is the confidence this person has, this energy has. But if they are someone who is a little flimsy and never really accept what he or she is doing, then what's the point of trying to prove yourself when they already have a wall up against you to not listen to you? That kind of a closed mindset is coming in. But yeah, I do see that now is the time that you start voicing your opinion and start saying no when it's required. We have the Strength card, Leo energy. Leo energy is coming through quite a bit, firing you up and reminding you to have faith in yourself. You have the emotional strength and intuition to go forward. We have the Emperor coming in, Sagittarian energy coming through, telling you that there are many people awaiting you professionally. Could be that you pick up public speaking, or that people will be coming in, or there could be some certain kind of male figure who comes through and really helps you pull it off. There's a bit of divorce energy which came through. So for those people who are looking for divorce, there may be a lawyer coming through for you. That's just an extra thing that they wanted me to tell you. We have the Judgment card coming in. Wow. So any kind of judicial impending decision, it will be made in your favor. And now is the time that you really, the intellectual part is coming through. You are bringing in justice in your life. And now is the time that you really take things into consideration for as they are and decide what you want. If not taking action on it immediately, but yes, what needs to end needs to come to an end. Completions are favored during this time. Lift yourself up. There's a lot of energy which is coming in. Stop doubting yourself. Understand your own worth. See, we have Eight of Arrows coming in, Eight of Swords coming through. Get a grasp of the reality. Really get a grasp of reality. Not the time to run away from things. If at all. All these things, if it's not resonating with your relationship, it could also be that there's something within you which is stopping you. Whether it is in terms of healing, in terms of going ahead, in terms of tapping into the spiritual realm, because you have certain kind, over the years you have closed yourself off from that because it's something unexplored and it kind of daunts you kind of a thing. Now is the time really. Metaphysics energy is coming through. But apart from that, like when you take the time to reflect on things, make sure that you're not becoming self-critical, because that also will stagnate your life. But really see things in reality as they are, rather than being biased, because now is the time that you bring in, like, voice your opinion. How are you connecting with the world is also something which is coming through. We have Seven of Lotus coming in reverse, which is talking about the procrastination will be coming to an end. You will be getting an angle, motivation, idea, inspiration to go forward. That is what is coming through right now. And we have the Four of Wands coming in reverse. This is usually a marriage card, which is coming in reverse. But apart from that, this is also talking about bringing in balance between your professional life and your personal life. Or the fact that you have been focusing on the finances a bit too much, that the personal life is getting a little of a backseat, and we need to bring equal amount of attention to each and every aspect of our life so that we can enjoy harmony and full satisfaction. That kind of energy is coming in. Don't waste your time trying to prove things where someone is quite closed off. Pick another time where you have also cooled down before speaking to this person. That is also what is coming through. Spiritually, we have Lady Portia coming in, divine order. Do what you feel is right. An important lesson is unfolding. Look at things as they are. Even certain kind of karmic patterns could be coming in. which we need to be aware of. Are we running away from the reality because we've become too comfortable in the way things have been, that we are not really moving forward in life, but kind of stagnated in our life, and getting the urge to change that is also what is coming through. We have faith coming in with humanity and benevolence. Stay calm, trust the good in yourself and others, see the light in the world coming through. We have Horus coming in, cosmic gateway, and I was just talking about someone being a little hesitant towards their spiritual journey. Your thoughts are magnetic and powerful, miraculous changes are occurring. So it could be like, you know, you're undergoing certain kind of drastic changes in your life which you didn't really expect because life was pretty good, but then coming to an understanding that I still have some things to achieve, that kind of a thing. And if you are doubting yourself, then the universe will wait for you till the time you gather up the strength and believe in yourself before they start getting in the results and the steps or the synchronicities that you have been waiting upon. Could be that you have been getting a lot of messages, synchronistic numbers also, 11 11, 12 12, 2 2 2, 4 4 4, reminding you on a repeat. But and the angels are trying to get your attention so that you start listening to what they have to say. That is also what is coming through. Open up, don't resist the path you are being led towards, is also what is coming through. I will be reading this one. And yes, if you have been feeling very negative about things, let's change that, because your thoughts are getting manifested into reality. Understand the power of your thoughts. Very important. We have Archangel Michael coming in. This came in for Sagittarians as well. And this is just replicating that there are certain things which were meant to go out of your life. And you are getting that angelic realm of Archangel Michael to cut cords with all those things which have now become obsolete. Move towards a higher vibrancy. Major call coming in. Last mid-monthly was karmic cleanse coming in, and it's coming through more and more. The whole I think the spirits are trying to give you an extreme version of things. If you have certain kind of intuition flowing in or certain kind of red flags, then pay attention to that. If not, make an immediate decision by waiting a little more to understand the whole situation and all of that, but make sure that you are aware of what is really happening and not cover yourself up with an illusionary veil. I don't know why is that coming in. Honestly, I don't know why is that coming in. This says, trusting heaven, you are safe, angels stand close, surrender your concerns and allow a miracle to occur. Miracle, miracle, miracle is coming in. A lesson is unfolding. Have faith in yourself. Stay calm. This may be an emotionally high time, and it is very important to remain calm, understanding your own powers and that there are changes which are occurring, and taking them in your stride, and knowing that you are making space to let go of the karmic weights for love and miracles and abundance to come into your life. The last one is awakening presence. The universe is with you. Wear a cloak of protection and love. From that illusionary veil surrounding you, we are letting that go. All the darkness, all the cloudiness which was stopping us to go forward will be going away now. There's a lot of angelic support coming through and pushing you to go towards a more meaningful life. Do what is for your higher good coming through over here. I will be reading this one over here. This says, you are connected to the universe and have the ability to manifest miraculous experiences. Your thoughts, words and actions are life magnets, drawing the energy that creates and cultivates your world. You have a stellar gateway chakra above your head, the crown chakra, a vortex of energy that is influenced by your own energy. You can place ideas into this vortex to create what you are seeking. The universe also offers you guidance, abundance, support and healing based on your capacity to connect to it and accept it. You have a real opportunity to further that connection now by sending prayers and intentions out into the cosmos. Become aware of how powerful your thoughts are I know that you are protected and guided and your dreams will be coming true, but make sure that you keep on taking steps for your higher good towards a more meaningful life, to understanding, unraveling your full potential. Because the next steps that you take are pretty much vital. That is also what is coming through right now. So anyways, that is coming through. I was thinking of certain kind of clarifiers, but if you want a more in-depth idea as to what changes are coming through, you may like to see the part one of the new moon in Aquarius. It has an energy update for all signs. You may look into all the signs which are available, including Venus and Mercury too. Or if you want to get more insight, you may like to check back when all of the other readings have come through. These are collective energies, and there were some really strong energies which were drawn to our attention today. So that is what is coming through. Do let me know if this resonated, and thank you for being part of the Moon and family. If you aren't already, then please do subscribe, and or just come back, check on our channel if that's your cue. Until next time, love, light, abundance and healing, clarity and strength to you all. Om Namah Shivaya. Keep that vibe high, my lovely moonian.